Good morning once again and welcome back to my channel. My name is Doris. Now listen, this cycle is broken and you have escaped. Before we get into this word, let us pray. Father, I thank you. I bless you. I glorify your name, Lord. Thank you for this opportunity to share your word. I pray, Lord Jesus, that this word is going to be a blessing. It's going to be an encouragement and a revelation. Anoint your word, Lord, as I release it. And I pray that whoever is going to hear this one, my Father, they shall hear that which you're saying in this hour. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. This is a beautiful word. It's going to really bless you. You see, you have been contending with generational curses in your bloodline. You have been contending with bloodline issues in your father's house. You have been contending with foundational strongholds in your family that are so stubborn, that are so unrelenting and just won't let you go. Now listen, that cycle is broken. That cycle of never-ending contending is coming to an end. Isaiah 49 verses 24 and 25, it reads, "Shall the prey be taken from the mighty, or the lawful captive delivered? But thus says the Lord, even the captive of the mighty shall be taken away, and the prey of the terrible shall be delivered. For I will contend with him that contends with you, and I will save your children." You have been thinking, how long will I have to keep contending? The cycle is never ending. You have been held captive, not because of anything that you have done wrong, not because of anything that you are doing wrong, but because of the sins of your forefathers. Listen, the cycle is broken and you are no longer a lawful captive. You have escaped from the snare of the evil cycle of your father's house. Psalms 124 verses 6 to 7, it says, "Blessed be the Lord, who has not given us as prey to their teeth. Our soul has escaped as a bird from the snare of the fowler." The snare is broken and we have escaped. Now understand this, the devil is very legalistic, and there is nothing that he can do or he's going to do outside the set laws and protocols in the word of God. I want to share with us a story in the Bible of a young lady who ended up, she ended a very wicked cycle in her bloodline, and she's a heroine. I consider her a heroine. You see, not much is said about her except for the fact that she was the daughter of King Jehoram of Judah and a wife of Jehoiada the priest. She was married to a priest. She was also the sister to King King Ahaziah, who was... This king was killed with Jehu, yes. Yeah, I think so. Basically, she comes from royalty. You see, she comes from royal blood, but nevertheless, defiled blood. Now, this lady served a king, and together with her husband took care of this king. And when he turned 7, they made sure that he was crowned king. Against all odds, she made it possible. By all means, she's a hero, a heroine. Probably you are now wondering who she is. Well, her name is Jehosheb, and she was the daughter of Athaliah and the granddaughter of Jezebel. These are two of the most wicked, evil, diabolical women recorded in scripture in the Old Testament. The book of Kings narrates the history of this family. Jehosheb probably had the worst family tree in scripture. I don't know, but God redeemed her from the iniquity of her father's house. If God did it for this lady, he can do it for you. And this is in the Old Testament. Imagine, everything was about the law. There was no grace in that period. You fulfill the law, you live. You break the law, you are dead. Now, let me give you a recap of what kind of a lineage this lady comes from. Then I'm going to share the word that the Lord gave me. Jehosheba's great-grandfather, King of Israel, seeking to make peace with the nation of Zidon, married his son Ahab to Jezebel. The genesis of Jehosheba's wicked bloodline begins right there. She was supposed to end up third generation of wickedness, but God intercepted the bloodline. God redeemed her and ended that wicked cycle in her life. Listen, the cycle is gonna be broken. You are no longer a lawful captive. You have escaped the wickedness and the evil of your father's bloodline. Jezebel, the grandmother of this lady, introduced Baal worship to her husband and then to Israel. Elijah shows up to destroy the prophets of Baal by fire, calls on God to end the drought, and then prophesy. Now this is key. Elijah prophesied a curse upon Ahab, Jezebel, and their descendants. Jehosheba's fate is sealed right there and then. Destruction is what was gonna be her portion. Destruction is what awaited her, because there was a prophecy that was released from the mouth of the servant of God upon her family. But God intercepted the mercies of God, the faithfulness of God. You see, like the mother Jezebel, Athaliah introduces Baal worship to her husband, who was the son of Jehoshaphat, and reintroduces Baal worship to Israel, like mother, like daughter. But Athaliah took wickedness to a whole new level. Now this woman was beyond diabolical. After her husband and son dies, she orders the annihilation of all of her male grandchildren so that she can ascend to the throne. Who does that? You see, with every generation, the wickedness intensifies. If God did not intercept in this bloodline, imagine the level and the degree of wickedness that Jehosheba would have operated in. You know, I was thinking, what if Athaliah had succeeded in her wicked deed? Hypothetically speaking, the seed of David would have ended. There will be no Messiah, because the Messiah was prophesied that he was going to come from the bloodline of David. Do you catch the revelation here? God intercepted that bloodline so that prophecy may be fulfilled. Now listen, there are things that God blocked in your bloodline that cannot affect you because of your destiny, because of what you carry. It may affect other family members, but not you. The cycle ends with you. The Lord is contending with what is contending with you. Now let's continue with the recap. Realizing what her mother was doing, Jehosheba steps in and saves the youngest child from assassination. And together with her husband, they protect this child and made sure that he is crowned king of Israel at 7 years. Athaliah is killed thereafter. Now, despite her wicked, evil bloodline, Jehosheba becomes one of the little known heroines in the Bible, in scripture. She did what was right before the Lord, and the cycle in her life was broken, and she did not end up a lawful captive like her predecessor. By virtue of her family tree, she was supposed to end up in wickedness. It doesn't matter the kind of family tree that you come from, because you did the right thing. Because you accepted Jesus as your Lord and Savior, you have done that which is right. The blood of Jesus has cleansed you. Your iniquity is pardoned. Your sin is forgiven. You are no longer a lawful captive. You have escaped. The blood of Jesus is speaking over your life. Jezebel, the grandmother of Jehoshaphat, was a wicked woman married to a wicked king, Ahab, and they were both destroyed. Athaliah, the mother of Jehoshaphat, was an evil queen married to a wicked king, Jehoram. They were both destroyed. Her brother, Ahaziah, was as wicked as the father and mother, and he was destroyed. Now, this is the kind of family that Jehoshaphat grew up in. Talk about dysfunctional families. This one was par excellence. You are always crying about your background, about the kind of family that you came from, about the dysfunctionality in your family. It can't measure up to this. This lady grew up in the midst of pure wickedness. Her fate was sealed, but look how Jehoshaphat's story turned out, quite the opposite. For starters, she never turned out as wicked as the women in her life. Secondly, she got married to a priest, not a wicked king like the women in her life. Thirdly, she was preserved, not destroyed, like her predecessors. Listen, your marital destiny, it's gonna be different. You can't go the same way of your predecessors. Your story is gonna be different. The cycle ends with you. Jehoshaphat chose to do what was right in the eyes of God, and the wickedness in her family, the wickedness in her bloodline did not affect her or corrupt her. As God, you see, as God protected Jehoshaphat and preserved her, so he's gonna do it for you. You are gonna be different. You fought to save your lineage. You fought so hard for your bloodline. You risked a lot for your bloodline. You are a hero before God, even if no one acknowledges it. You are a hero. Your story is gonna be different from that of your predecessors. You are rewriting your family history. The script is gonna be different. When you are mentioned in your family, when you are mentioned in your bloodline, it's gonna be acknowledged that you are the one that God used to break a cycle, an evil cycle in your family. What the enemy stole from your bloodline, what the enemy destroyed in your bloodline is gonna be restored to you, because you are the one who fought the battle of your bloodline, and the one that overcomes is the one who is entitled to the plunder. The one who wins the battle is the one that takes the plunder. It is all gonna be restored to you. You have escaped the iniquity of your father's house, and the cycle is broken. You have escaped. Listen, it doesn't matter the background that you have come from. God is able to intercept that evil cycle. God is able to intercept that cycle of iniquity and set you free and use you. Use you as an example. Use you as a sign. Use you as a point of reference for others that you broke a generational curse, a bloodline issues. You are gonna be a reference point in your family for generations to come. You are rewriting history, and you are leaving a legacy for the next generation to build on. You have escaped. May the Lord abundantly bless you. I love you so much, but the Lord, He loves you so much more. He loves you than everlasting love, and there is nothing that can separate you from His love, which is in Christ Jesus. And always know that I do appreciate you for all that you do for me and for the ministry. Shalom.